Starting off today with Diabolically Decadent Brown Ale from Dastardly Villain Brewing. They call themselves makers of beer-flavored beer. Now, how do you argue with that? They've got a whole big story on the back of the can, and I'm not going to read the whole thing. You can pause it if you want to. But one of the interesting claims is that this beer pairs well with cookies. I'll have to try that when I finish the video. It's a little hoppier than I expected, but it's quite nice. So, tonight, I am taking a closer look at this desoldering gun, this vacuum suction, if you want, desoldering tool that I got from Banggood a couple of weeks ago. I'll put the link to the mailbag up there if you haven't seen it already. This is the model S993A desoldering tool. This particular one runs at 100 volts. It's 100 watts, so lots of heat. It can heat up to anywhere between 350 and 450 Celsius using the little adjustment down here on the handle. Essentially, this is a combination of a soldering iron or soldering gun that can heat up 100 watts or throw 100 watts of heat, combined with a vacuum desoldering tool, except for this one's got a motor in it that pulls continuously. And then it sucks the melted solder up through the hollow shaft and deposits it in this little container here. The suction pump is pulling air through that container, through the hollow tip and into there. And there's a few layers of filtering inside this little removable container here. So you can see down inside there, there's a little metal piece that that any flying bits of solder crash into. And it's got four air gaps around it. Then on the back, there is this little felt filter that prevents gunk from getting into the workings of the pump. And then in the back here, there is another filter behind it, further keeping gunk out of the pump. And then I'm assuming there's just plumbing going back to the little vacuum pump inside there. And that is spring-loaded, and it's got a couple of rubbery gaskets on the front and back. And that just goes in like that. Give it a little twist, and there it is. The only other feature on it is the trigger, which turns the vacuum pump on and off. So obviously, I am going to test this thing out, because it would be a pretty short video if I didn't. But I'm also going to take it apart and see what's inside. But first, the other things that came with it. This nice hefty stand, which has a sponge for cleaning the tip, a little tray for that that just slips into there all nicely. Then a bag with a few accessories. There are two of these fairly stiff, needly things that you can shove up the snout of this to clear any solder jams out. And there's two spares of each of the two filters. So the first safety test I'm going to do is just to make sure that it is actually grounded at the tip. And it is. Perfect. That's always a good thing. Test it first or take it apart first? You already know the answer to that, don't you? Take it apart and see what all's inside, because this could be interesting in there. So it looks like it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8 screws on it. I'll just quickly yoink those out, and we'll see what secrets await us inside this guy. Okay, there is all the screws out. Let's see what's inside. That clamshell comes off fairly nicely. So we have a fairly chunky motor, the noise suppression capacitor across the back end. That's nice. There is a little diaphragm pump that just runs on this little crank here. You can see it pumping up and down. And there's a little piece of pipe up there with a spring in it, because it's in suction, so we don't want the pipe to collapse. There's that little unit. Okay, that's all very nice. And at this end, we have the connections to the tip. There's our ground connection to the tip. Very nice. And then we have the heating connections. You can see them a little bit better down here. There's two white wires, a red wire, and a green wire, I believe. The trigger is just a little micro switch. Interesting. And then there's the two wires going to there. Okay. Fairly straightforward. Let's go deeper. See what's on the other side of this little circuit board. I assume it's just the temperature control stuff for the iron tip. Yeah, that's pretty much what it is. We've got a bridge rectifier there and just a straight up diode. Here is the AC line coming in, and there's the ground going up to the tip. The potentiometer that sets the temperature, LED to indicate power on. What else? A beefy transistor up there that looks like it's got a bit of heatsink goop on it, but no place for it to go to. Capacitor, a couple of diodes. What is that little chip there? LM358. Tis an op amp. So it's probably acting like a comparator, comparing the setting here against the thermistor coming in from up in the tip, I would guess. And that's probably just a max min limit, most likely. Okay, fairly straightforward little board, not too much going on. A little bit of excess flux on the back, but if you've seen my soldering in the past, you know I'm not offended by a little bit of excess flux. Let's get it back together and put it to work. And there we are back together. Let's just see if it still works. Plug it in. Yep, we got a power light. Excellent. So I'll set that kind of to mid-range, about 410-ish. I'll let it preheat. Give that a soak, because I just love watching the sponges puff up. That's so cool. It's the simple things in life. That ought to do. Let's start with this old PC power supply here. What should we try and pull off it? Something that's on a big pad, maybe. You notice I've already started to pull a few things off. Let's try this capacitor here. Just put that tip down onto it. Wow, look at that. It's that hole right there, nice and clean. You see my finger behind it? That is awesome. Since I'm in the neighborhood, might as well get the other end of that same capacitor. Get on there. Yep, nice and clean. Let's see if we can release this heat sink, because that's going to make it work. Actually, for that, I might crank this guy up to like full tilt at 450. Because the heatsink's going to be a challenge. Or not. Where's the other end of it? Over. What else is holding that down? When, where are you? Right about there. Wow. That wasn't even difficult. Although I've got all those other power devices on there. Fine, I'll just pull them all off. Why not? This is so much easier than screwing around with wick and stuff. I like it. I'm just going to keep banging away on this thing, because taking these large power devices off is actually a good test for it. Makes it work hard. And we'll just see what that reservoir looks like afterwards. One heatsink complete with some power transistors on it. That was surprisingly easy. I was expecting that heat sink to steal all the heat, but I guess there's enough mass in that tip that it can actually handle it. That's very cool. And I do like a good salvaged heat sink. I think that guy's, oh yeah. Can we use the tip cleaner yet? Let's just do that just cause. And, that's one thing. If you don't put it down exactly right into the holder taps the suction button, but only for a second. That's not a big deal. So I am going to unplug this guy, let it cool down, and then I'm going to clean out the reservoir and just see how easy that goes. One moment, please. So while we wait for that to cool off, might as well take a look at the listing on Banggood. Currently, it's going for $99 American, and it's on sale. Pretty good discount, actually, too. This is the 110 to 130 volt North American version. It says down below, ignore the picture, because the picture's got the Australian version. So obviously, if you're in Australia, you can buy an Australian version of this. They also have, I believe, a UK version and a EU version. So choose accordingly. But the link down below is going to go to this one. And then you can just search for your own country's version using the model number there. So there's what comes with it. Everything that I already showed you on my workbench, the stand, the tool itself, the tip cleaning sponge, the cleaning sponge holder, a couple of needles to clean out the tip, filters. Yeah, there they are. And there was a little pamphlet with it that I've already thrown out because it wasn't all that informative. I mean, what more do you need to say about this thing, really? The specs, basically what was written on the side. This particular one's AC 110 volts, 120, whatever, North American voltage. 90 watts ceramic heating core and 10 watts for the motor. It can heat between 350 and 450. That little circuit board claims to be able to maintain plus or minus 2 degrees accuracy. Interesting. It can run continuously. Sure. It comes with a 1 millimeter tip and there are replacement tips available. Ooh, look, a handy link. So there is the replacement tips you can get for it, anywhere from a 1, 1.5, or 2 millimeter orifice on the end. So let's go back and see if it's cooled off enough to take that solder reservoir out and see how easy it is to clean. Ooh, that's still fairly warm. Oh well, I'll risk it. I think I'm just going to use that tray to dump the solder out in. Yeah, that part's not too hot anymore. It's just the other part. So that's a fair bit. And there is a fair bit in the back of there too. Let's see if I can get a scraping tool in there. It's not really adhered all that hard. It's just kind of splattered on there. And that comes off fairly easily. Well, oh, okay. I just poked that right out the back. That'll make it easier to clean, I guess. Yeah, so that isn't really stuck on there. It's just kind of conformed. Okay. There is. Yeah, okay. So that's not too bad at all. And that's just, like I said, a little metal piece that the solder collides with. It provides an indirect air path to the back. Okay. You just shove him back in there. That's good. There is the filter. It's not completely disgusting. Actually, it's not that bad at all. That's, yeah, I don't think there's any metallic stuff on there. I guess just fumes and stuff from the flux or whatever. And that one doesn't look like it's got too much pollution on it either. So that's good. That means the filters are doing their job. But in the other video, somebody in the comments suggested that I put a piece of spring or something in there to kind of disrupt this stuff when it's flying to the back so it doesn't actually get all the way to the back, which is an interesting idea, but I don't really have any springs that are all that, that would fit that job. But what I do have is some of this stuff, which is, you know, this stuff here, right? So I think I will just tease out a little bit of this, not too much. just a little bit. Snip a chunk off and toss that in there to intercept the flying debris. And I don't want so much in there that it will disrupt the airflow. That would be counterproductive, I think. Just having a little bit of material in there to sort of catch the solder in midair and keep it from building up on the back there. I think that would be a good little mod. I guess we'll find out in due course. Just stuff that back in there. I think I'm going to go just off camera because you've already seen me desoldering stuff. I think I'm going to go and pull a few more components off these boards and just see if that actually does what I think it'll do. Well, that got a fair number of components off the board. Let's see what's in there now. Actually, I think I can take that off just without doing that. Yeah, I can. So I'll just set that up there and unplug it. And let's see what's going on in here now. Take my little bit of fluff and floss out of there. Pull my tray out again. Oh yeah, that's much better. No big chunks in the back there. That's awesome. The chunky bits all got caught up in here. And since they're still fairly warm at the front, they seem to have stuck to the brass or copper or whatever this stuff is. That's okay, though. That stuff is cheap and easy, and as you saw, I've got a huge chunk of it. So I can just toss that bit out, because who cares? And cram this other bit back in and just carry on. I like that. I think that's a pretty good little mod. And thanks to whoever it was that suggested that I put something up front there to sort of catch that flying debris before it hits the filter. I like that idea. So I think that is going to be a very handy little tool, especially for when I'm doing repairs. But also, as I said, in case I decide that I want to salvage some stuff, I think that heat sink is a win. I'm not sure what I'm going to use it for, but heat sinks are always useful to have around. Anyway, if you have any comments, questions about this thing, throw them down in the comment section as usual. If I don't answer it, somebody will. And if you've got one of these and have some experience, absolutely share it. I'd love to hear about it. Anyway, Thanks for watching. I appreciate that, everybody. There will be a link to this and to replacement tips down in the description, as you might expect. I will talk to you later. And I think I'm going to try and find some cookies to see how well this does pair with it.